Hello everybody, welcome back to some Binding of Isaac. Don't even need to say it, but Wrath of the Lamb gameplay. Basically just, you know, trying to continue onwards here and, you know, work ourselves into that Platinum God. It's random. We're gonna random Kane. I think that is a solid random after the terrible luck that I had with Eve last time. But when do I not have terrible luck with Eve? So I think I've realized, and you know, this has probably been stated, I'm not gonna bring up the comments issue again, but it's probably been stated 100 times in the comments, the 2 achievements apart from the 8 that have been recently added that I'm missing. Platinum God was one that I've mentioned before. The other one is not a secret achievement so much, well, I guess it is a secret achievement that it's not really advertised, but it's the one that you get for getting, like, all of the cat items in one run that actually turns you, you know, into our favorite feline friend. So I guess I'm gonna be on the lookout for both of those. You know, I need, like, 3 of, like, Guppy's Paw, Guppy's Head, Guppy's Tail, or 9 Lives. So I need like 3 of those 4 items in one run. We'll see how it works. I'm not gonna guarantee anything, because obviously that is entirely based on luck. We got the inner eye, which is a triple shot. It's fantastic, actually. If we get some bombs, there's some money to be had over there. But anyway, yeah, you know, like it gives us something else to shoot for, something else to maybe not plan for, but if we do come across those items, we can of course make something happen. I can't believe I let that nub get large enough to spit out a spider, and I can't believe I got hit there, but luckily there is. Hey, a little bit of health right there. Why not fight the boss right away? Let's just pin. We're gonna be doing a pretty substantial amount of damage to him. Remember, triple shot, I think the way it works is it... each one of your shots does the same amount of damage as, like, your normal shots. But there's 3 of them, so obviously you can. If you hit with all 3, you do triple your damage. But you shoot 3 times slower, or like 1/3 of the speed, I think, is the way triple shot works. It's the way quadruple shot works anyway. At least when you pair it with, like, a brimstone. So we got some health here. Oh, I didn't even realize we were on the Cellar XL. Yeah, you know, we might as well continue fighting the bosses here. I mean, we can always leave. Oh, I hate this dude so much. It's the first time I've ever fought this boss, though. Like, I've seen him before, but I've never fought him before. This is weird. I didn't even realize he was a boss. I thought he was just a random enemy type. Luckily, when you shoot him, he seems to slow down. Which kind of nullifies the problems that I have with him before. But anyway, this guy seems to be not so bad in the whole scheme of things, I guess. Oh, almost got to me there. Maybe he has received a... ooh, that was close. Maybe he's received a nerf lately as well. Because I remember him being a total pain in the ass. No, actually, the problem is that he actually gets faster as he goes along. Okay, so we got tons of health now. Basically doubled our health on this floor. But we will, of course, continue exploring. I do have a key on my person right now, which guarantees that I'll be able to visit the second treasure room. Would love to get a bomb bag in that second treasure room and maybe be able to pick up some of this money that's just sitting over there. I actually pointed in real life thinking that maybe you guys would see, but you know, no such luck. Hopefully none of you saw anyway. That might be terrifying. Maybe we'll find a library on this floor as well, but you know, can't guarantee that. But I suppose the chance exists. Well, I'm gonna take damage there, yes. Really no way around that, was there? After I froze at the first few seconds, anyway. Other than this, we'll just continue exploring. It's not like I have, like, a reroll to plan for or worry about, so we can basically just make our way through here. I'm not gonna say mindlessly, but, you know, a little bit more mindlessly than I do on a typical Isaac run. Than I do on a typical random run, I guess, because I typically get Isaac on my random runs. I should go to that self-sacrifice room once we finish all of these rooms and figure out if I'm actually gonna need any of this health that's sitting down on the ground. Hey, Spirit Heart, basically just by randomly shooting some poop, not gonna complain about that. It's been a very lucky room. I guess with Kane, I should always shoot the poop, because you never know what kind of drops you're gonna get. I think that was originally the line in Forrest Gump. You never know what drops you're gonna get. Life is like the Binding of Isaac. You never know which drops you're gonna get, except when you fight one of the Horsemen of the Apocalypse, in which case you're gonna get a cube of meat. Okay, come on, man. Get down here. Take your sweet-ass time, Leaper Spider. I hate your kind. Okay, we got a dime in there. That is also worth a bomb if we could ever come across one of those. But even if we don't, you know, the game has been fairly good to me so far. Can't complain too hard. Definitely take out this neutral fly to ensure that I don't accidentally run into him a little bit later. Almost got hit by that spider. And I think it's pretty clear that we'll be able to go to the self-sacrifice room, which will hopefully contain a bomb of some sort. We get all stats up. Apparently that's something that I get on like every single floor now. So we got good damage, very good health as Kane. We'll go to the self-sacrifice room, see if we can't get ourselves some improvised explosive device. that we can use to access that dime and maybe even make the shop worthwhile. If not on this floor, then on the next floor. So we'll pop in here. This is actually going to cost us our spirit heart. Never mind. Never mind. Okay, well, we're not going to get a bomb, but we are doing very well with respect to our health. Picked up 3 spirit hearts, which is basically 2 spirit hearts because we lost one in the middle there. And now we'll head down to the next floor, having had a very, very good first floor as Kane, although I am abandoning like 30 cents on the ground. Oh well, not a whole lot we can do about that, so we'll just move onwards and I guess continue our quest for a spacebar item. Might I suggest a Guppy's Paw in this situation? Would have killed 2 birds with 1 stone, really. First we got our treasure room. We got the Game Kid, that's a good spacebar item. But it is one that I will be probably looking to get rid of as soon as possible. Well, not as soon as possible, but I mean, there's no real incentive for me to hold. It's not one of the game-breaking spacebar items, in my personal opinion anyway. Getting a lot of heart drops. Again, good for self-sacrifice rooms, but I have enough spirit hearts that I can't really make use of those yet without losing those precious blue gems that are providing me with sustenance in life right now. So I'm trying to take out these neutral flies one at a time. In order to put myself in a better position, to not be hit by them in the very near future. The slot machine raises an interesting predicament, one that I will touch on in a second, perhaps. Because I want to go to the slot machine to get money, or to give money, to potentially get keys. And I really want to use the game kit on this room, to be honest with you. And I almost had to right there, but I think I worked it out okay. Got hit again. That was bad. So I want to visit the slot machine to get keys, but I also want to save this money in case I come across like a judgment or something, or fortune teller. Hey, we got a key anyway. Who we have for a boss here? We have the horseman. There you go. Well, let's use Game Kid right away. I don't really care which of these things I kill first. They're both annoying as hell. So this will give us the ability to fly. So I will be getting rid of the Game Kid as soon as possible. Basically traded a key for a chariot card, for lack of a better word. Because that is what the Game Kid functioned as right there, and we're gonna basically treat it as if it's one-time use. We're gonna pick up the ability to fly. We're gonna go in here and talk to Satan, and he's gonna give us something awesome. Demon Baby or Ouija Board. I mean, Ouija Board is pretty good when you have the ability to fly, so we'll take that. Always feels bad when you trade one heart for Ouija board, because it's something that shows up so often just in random, like, golden chests. But this is going to allow us to now pick up a ton of keys, because we have the ability to fly. Self-sacrifice room never has appealed to me less. But we might go to the other self-sacrifice room, because I have enough blue hearts. You know, losing half a spirit heart for the chance at something good is an okay trade, in my mind. Now, flying, plenty of those. We might as well open this golden chest, to be honest with you, because I desperately need bombs, and I have a decent amount of keys. It's a speed upgrade? Yeah, we'll take it. I mean, it's not really that useful for us. But, there's worse things. We could probably play this slot machine a few times as well. Let's play this. You know, maybe we'll get some bombs or keys out of it. Pretty Fly is good, too. It's already paid for itself. You know an item that I haven't seen that often since Wrath of the Lamb came out? Halo of Flies. That used to be like fairly common. I'm still getting decent amounts of pretty flies, but Halo of Flies is not really coming out all that often. So we did just get like a nickel there, but I'm just going to invest that right back into the system again. Would love to get more bombs. More spirit hearts is cool too. More keys. I'm not going to be too picky about it, to be honest with you. And we do have that chance of getting a dollar bill. But I feel like we're probably just going to basically run out of cash here. It's taken us forever, but alright, more red hearts I can't possibly use. Another pretty fly, that's good. Maybe we'll make our own Halo of Flies. And a key. Okay, well, that definitely was worth our time. Let's see what we got here. Double bombs, okay, that cost us half a spirit heart, big deal. We'll head down to the next floor. Looking, you know, pretty solid with respect to our items right now. Ability to fly, Ouija board, decent damage as a result of the all stats upgrade that I got. Not fantastic damage, but decent damage, to be sure. We got enough keys to visit some treasure rooms. This is like the exact opposite of my Eve run that I just did. If you haven't seen that episode, go ahead and, go back and watch that. It's pretty short, so, I'll wait. So we do have Judgment, that will be a... Judgment is like the shop you go to when you don't have enough money to go to the shop, if that makes any sense. Like, If you don't have 15 cents, like let's say you have like 8 cents, you can go to Judgment for the chance. That was bad. For the chance to get a good item. Which, and I'm not ragging on Judgment here. I feel like that's what he does. So I just used our card here to see what direction I want to go to, what kind of secret rooms you might be missing. I mean, the world card is really valuable in a situation like this where you don't have very many bombs. In fact, I don't have any bombs, but presumably I'll pick up one at some point on this floor. I hope. Spider's trolling the shit out of me. Got two of clubs. That gives us two bombs or doubles our existing bombs. So obviously I'm going to wait to use that as long as possible. I could use it to get two bombs, which is fine, but I would rather hold on to it and, you know, use it to turn six bombs into 12 bombs, if at all possible, so I don't have this problem again in the future. Looks like today's drinking game is every time I say, if at all possible. Alright, we're gonna be dealing with this. I don't have a bomb with which to access. Okay, I probably will use two of clubs here then. The reason being, oh, I don't have to worry about this room at all because I don't have to get in a lane to shoot these guys. I can just shoot them with my Ouija board. Okay, Ouija board paid for itself. But two of clubs here will allow me to access this tinted rock. Maybe we'll get a damage upgrade. Maybe we'll get more keys. Maybe we'll get more bombs. Who knows? Maybe we'll get more spirit arts. That would be worthwhile as well. For now, we got Mom's coin purse, which is just more pills. I guess we'll see what the pills do first. Remember, Kane can't get bad pills. That's not a great pill, but it's not a bad pill. Tears up is a good pill. Bombs are key. Not good. That's not good right now. Tears up again is a good pill. Well, we will blow this up. Hope for a key, I guess. Get a spirit heart out of it. Now, hopefully we don't run into the same problem with keys that we had with bombs. Okay, we got Krampus. That's good. Passive damage upgrade. Not going to complain about that. He should be very easy for us to kill, considering the upgrades that we have right now. I'm just going to try to stay out of the way of his laser attack whenever I can. Because otherwise, like, the pony control is a little floaty. So I can pretty easily, like, accidentally get myself into his range when I'm trying to just shoot diagonally. But we're going to be fine. If I don't take damage against Krampus, I consider it a victory. But remember, I did just pick up a spirit heart a second ago. Man, I hope that bombs or key pill doesn't end up screwing me. Sometimes those are useful. Most of the time, when they just catch you by surprise, you're like, oh, well, fuck. That was a good example of me almost dodging into the laser there. But Krampus, I think I have his number finally. I mean, it... Such convenient timing, right? I think I finally have his number, though, more or less, after, you know, again, probably like 30 fights. Terrible dodging. Again, that nullifies the spirit heart that I picked up. But again, getting the lump of coal is certainly worth it. It's a good damage upgrade. Stacks well with triple shot, I'm assuming. And now we will just, you know, look for the secret room. We know where it is, I guess. We got Judgment. I'll pop a scent over to him. Maybe he'll give me a key. He's a nice guy like that. Maybe later. We'll go to the secret room, which will hopefully contain a skeleton key or something. I don't know. 9 cents. Which is bad because we can't even go to the shop to spend it. I can't even shoot the fire because of Ouija board. It just takes too long. We do have a mini boss up here. And you know my philosophy on mini bosses is like, feed them shit and keep them in the dark. No, philosophy on mini bosses is you pretty much always want to fight them unless, you know, you have terrible speed and you're going up against Lust or something. I just really hope it's not Envy or Super Envy because those dudes are annoying as hell. Now I'm just hoping for two key drops because I would love to go to this library as well. If we can get Technology 2, oh, such terrible dodging. If we get Technology 2, which is a library drop occasionally, in conjunction with the current items I already have, we'll find ourselves in a very good situation. We're fighting against Pride. Kind of thought I was going to get hit there. I guess I should have doubled my bombs earlier. Because now, I don't have as many as I did a second ago. Okay, seriously, Pride? Kind of being an asshole right now. There we go. Okay, we got a key. That's all I needed. And two of diamonds doubles our money. Let's use that right away so that we can hold on to our two of clubs. Could go to the shop first and potentially, you know, like, buy a key in there in addition to an item. But I'm going to play it safe and go to the treasure room first. Odds are I am going to want what the treasure room is selling. Unless it's Ipecac. Might put me in kind of a tricky spot. Triple shot Ipecac. I wonder if it stacks and makes like three Ipecac shots. If so, I mean, that might be incredibly powerful. It might also be incredibly dangerous. Much like my genitalia. But anyway, we got one spider left. We got 29 cents, so we've done a lot for ourselves money-wise. We've, like, trumped Kane. Like, not trumped in a Euchre sense or a bridge sense, trumped like a Donald Trump. Was really hoping for another key there. Joker's good, too. Wow, it's technology, too. Weird, man. Oh, but Kane only has one eye, so I just lost my triple shot. Okay, well... Okay, let's use that. The reason I want to not use the Joker card right now is because... if I take that down, if I use it on this floor, I think it's just gonna take me to that Krampus room that I was just in. But if I take it down to the next floor, we're gonna find ourselves potentially at a deal with the angel, deal with the devil, who knows. I'm gonna give Judgment more of this money, because I don't have any keys anyway. Bombs are fine too. I can deal with either, really? HP upgrade is good. Maybe I can find a way to give that to Satan on the next floor. And we got the Hanged Man. Oh, worthless card, okay. So we are unfortunately not going to get another key here, or another two keys to access the library and whatnot. I hate getting technology 2 on Kane, because it makes it so we only fire the technology shots, which don't do, you know, particularly insane damage, you know. I had a feeling, yep, this is XL, unfortunately. Well, we might as well play it once, because I did it by accident. So I'm just... Oh, God, that was a horrible dodge. I think, you know, we are doing okay damage with technology 2, actually. There's a money back. Not superb damage. Thank God that put out the fire over there. But enough damage that I don't think I have to worry about, like, getting a damage upgrade. It's a nice attention to detail as well that Kane, you know, doesn't fire out of his other eye. It's better this way than have technology to just plain not work as Kane. Like, imagine if the technology normally came out of the other eye and Kane just was, it was inaccessible for him. But anyway. There's a key for us, which is fantastic. We should have two treasure rooms on this floor, so I'm going to need to amass as many keys as possible. Judgment is certainly a possibility, but we might want to wait on it a little bit. I was fully prepared to take damage there. I wasn't even going to try to dodge. The only thing that sucks about this is that the Ouija board that I paid for is now useless. But that's okay. We got it. Oh, that was a huge mistake. Why are trinkets so rare right now? Yeah, so I lost that key, in case you were not looking, but hopefully we'll be able to pick up some more. It's a shame, because, you know, on a floor like this, you want as many keys as possible. Picked up the Eternal Heart, because, again, we're never going to be able to, like, leave the boss room before we... There we go. Good. Fish head. I don't know what it does, but we'll stick with it. I think it works kind of like Mulligan or something, where when we hit enemies, we get more flies around us. Or maybe it works the other way, like the, I forget what the other name of the name of the other item was, but... Damn, golden chest, man. Oh, I want it. I don't care if it hurts. I lost a spirit heart there, but it's okay. Yeah, I have no idea what Fishhead does. Let's just cut that conversation short. Technology 2, I was totally wrong. The damage it's doing is absolutely fine right now. Let's get ourselves back to full health. Obviously, if possible, I would prefer to use my key to access at least one of the treasure rooms, although the shop is going to be worthwhile as well. But, you know, like, the thing is, I can justify not going to the shop and instead using that key on the treasure rooms, or even golden chests, because I can use the money that I have to go to Judgment instead. So we got Speedball, speed and shot speed increases, so we're just basically going to be super fast. Why don't I just hang out, like, right here? Yeah, now, smart guy, now they can't actually hit me. Again, perfect timing, right? Luckily, we have decent health. Not great, but decent. There's a shop and a self-sacrifice room. The good thing, like the silver lining of these dark clouds of not having many spirit hearts, is that I feel much better going to self-sacrifice rooms, because I know I can replenish my health more easily. So there we go. Took a little bit of damage there, but it's not a huge deal. Instead, we'll be able to come back in here. Yeah, you know, we got a lot of health. Why not? We got conga lines. We've already lost our benefit from the self-sacrifice room, except for one fly that's just kind of trucking around. He is now dead. So we didn't gain too much, but we didn't lose too much either. We got a lot of money, let's spend some of this at Judgment. What's money if you can't spend it, right? Hopefully he will. Tower, not a good card. Yes, that's more what I was looking for. Keys are fine. I can deal with that. Should use the Joker card, I guess, too, just to see what we come across. Because if it's an angel room, that was good. If it's an angel room, absolutely want to visit that. Let's use it. It's Satan. He's got rage and 9 lives. Why not? Let's mix it up a little bit. Normally, I would play it a little bit more cautiously, but we did just pick up a little bit of extra health. So we'll use Rage. Again, I'm not 100% positive that it even stacks with Technology 2, but if it does, then we've just created a, you know, a laser-fied electrified monster here in our version of Kane. Although he could use a little bit more health. I mean, despite me saying that I just picked up a little bit of health, could still use a little bit more. Just to put myself over the top. Money, totally fine. Again, if we can get maybe one more key. The money issue is not a problem. I mean, we're probably going to fight greed in the shop, which is not so good, I guess. I would prefer to stand here and take these guys out, if at all possible. I really don't want to get in contact with those blue spiky things. Historically, we have not had a good history with each other. That was a terrible dodge, but again, there's tons of health just sitting around, so not sweating it too much. Now, can I pop this open without getting hit? Yes. More bombs, which means secret room is, you know, in the... How did I blow myself up there? I think I created some flies with that fish head that ended up actually hurting me. Let's see what we got in the treasure room. Ipecac laser. Alright. I think maybe our laser does poison damage now. Ipecac, so common. I wonder why that item needs to have its coefficient turned down or something. Alright, but we did pick up a key there. That was the kind of unsung drop that I just got. That was a horrible dodge. I'm not sure what I was thinking. Should have just dove for the middle as soon as I could have. We must be going to the boss room. And maybe what we'll do is, you know, we'll fight one boss. Then we'll come back. And go to the shop, because, you know, why not at this point? I gotta get some health anyway. Liberty cap. I'm gonna stick with the thing that spawns blue flies. And we got the fallen. Okay, that's actually pretty good. So we're fast enough to get around the fallen, and we find ourselves in a good position, because if I can get both of these half-fallens lined up, yeah, I can do double the damage, basically. And, wow, they melted pretty fast. I did take some stupid damage there, but we're gonna get some back. We got Brother Bobby. Brother Bobby's alright. I'm not going to complain. And we'll, you know, make our way back, pick up some of this health. The other alternative, I guess, is that I could just hurt myself enough to go into the boss trap room, but that seems a little bit risky. It's okay, I didn't think that would work, but it worked. Let's blow up the slot machine. Contained therein, we find a key, which is good. Nothing to use that key on, actually, now, except for there is one golden chest up here. So let's go up there and pick that up. We are back to full health. There's a tinted rock here, which I must have missed on my first pass. Gives us a spirit heart. Okay, everything's coming up Millhouse for this final fight, maybe. More bombs, more keys, more money. Make our way down to the shop where we're almost inevitably going to fight a mini-boss here. Like, there's no way around the fact that this is probably greed. Simply because we haven't fought another mini-boss on this. Wow, okay. Well, we'll definitely pick up the spirit heart. We'll definitely pick up the nun habit. And then we'll just bounce, I guess. Yeah, so we've pretty much cleaned out this floor with the exception of the secret room, but I'm not going to waste too much looking for that. Nun's Habit, I mean, you guys have probably noticed by now and are screaming at me that I almost never use the pony's spacebar effect. I haven't used it at all in this video, I think. It's not a bad spacebar effect, it just distracts me when I use it. So the Nun's Habit is not going to be great for that, but, you know, if in case, let's say I come across, like, a flying item that is a passive, unlike the pony... and I also come across like a Book of Revelations or something a little bit later. So the Nun's Habit is something that, you know... I mean, I'm not going to use this money for anything else anyway at this point in the game, so I might as well just use it to pick up an item that may indeed prove to be worth its weight in gold a little bit later. My mom is basically dead already. I lost a spirit heart as a result of that, but I picked up +2 damage, which is fantastic. And we will head down to the next floor, which is not XL, which makes me happy. Halo of Flies actually saved me. Well, it's not technically Halo of Flies yet, because I only have 2. Alas, but, you know, we are in a very good position here. Technology 2 basically working like a powerful version of Brimstone, which is, I guess, kind of ironic, because Brimstone doesn't even work anymore, according to what people have said, but I haven't had it spawn in 1.2 yet, so, you know, hopefully that gets fixed in the next couple of days when the patch comes out. I'm still not sure if those 8 achievements have been added to the game at the time of this recording. I think they have, because people are tweeting me non-stop. What do you think Kane's eye could be? I don't know. But if it gives him the ability to fire Technology 2 and the triple shot that I rightfully earned at the same time, I am for it. Just keep making our way through here in case you missed it. I've already lost the spirit arts that I had previously amassed. It's alright. I'm not going to sweat it too much. Just need a little bit more health, if possible. Because apparently I am terrible at dodging. We got a blood bank. Oh, I walked into it by accident. Well, give us some money. Let's blow it up. Blood banks, usually, at least in my perhaps biased opinion, oh my god, I'm getting hit so much, usually pay out with hearts. I don't want Cursed Skull either. Man, we might end up losing it on this floor. This is disappointing. I just need a little bit of health. No. Okay, good. Okay, now we might win the game. Or beat the game. I hate when people say win the game. You play to win the game. Okay, just ignore this. Pick up some extra health, please. More money. Yeah, just in time, right? Just in time. What I should be using the pony spacebar effect for is actually to give me some invincibility when I know I'm gonna get hit, but I don't have those kind of reflexes. I can figure that out strategically in my brain, but actually making my hands do it is out of the question. Okay, so we got a dead end. We got a key. Again, largely useless at this point, unless we come across some golden chests. And in fact, golden chests could be exceptionally useful for us. Could get a passive flying item, could get, you know, fate, which gives us flying plus an eternal heart. Who knows? But for now, we're just going to focus on what we got, and what we got is 75% of our, you know, possible life. Hopefully soon to be 100%, and we have almost an entire floor explored. Floral the Explorer. I'm trying to make it work. It's not working out so hot. But these runes are easy enough for me. Hopefully we get the Womb XL next, or the Womb, not XL, hopefully, next time. Extra half heart is fine, sure, why not? We got another key out of it as well. It must have meant there was a tinted rock somewhere in that pile. We gotta be getting close to the boss room, right? Oh, and there we go, there's full health. Might as well pick that up, of course, the reason being that, you know, everything on the womb does one heart worth of damage at least, anyway. So you can run that situation through in your head to see why I didn't just wait until I got hit one more time before I picked that up. I assume my math on that is right. Stranger things have happened than me being wrong in a Binding of Isaac video. Okay, now I feel like an idiot. I should have waited. We can go to the Mob Trap room, though. At least see if there's something awesome in there. But if there is not, we will just move on. We will just move on, because these, you know, utero Mob Trap rooms are pretty hard. Usually contain, like, a Chub and a Peep or something. Larry Jr.'s, which actually would be fairly easy. And we got Teratoma. I always fight Teratoma when I'm flying. I imagine this is going to be pretty easy. Because, you know, we can basically just do that, and there's some more health for us. We got another speed and shot speed upgrade. Yeah, probably totally worthless. Unless, and I mentioned this in an earlier video, unless the way the technology works is it does like X hits per second. I don't want to waste my key to hurt you. I'd rather waste a bomb. If it does like X hits per second and shot speed up and tears up actually like increase the number of, like the frequency of times that it actually does damage. Because there's got to be times when technology is hitting something when it doesn't actually do damage, and then times when it does, I think. If that makes any sense at all. We got Judgment, which is fantastic. Reason being, it gives us another chance to pick up a spacebar item. Or, just an item in general. Yeah, I'll take that. We can go to the arcade. I was hoping there would be a fortune teller, but no such luck. And we should be able to use... That was pretty much what I was going to say, wasn't it? Like, use this heart out here to leverage us into getting some more HP upgrades. But, hey. Getting a blood bag on the first check is A-okay with me. We got a lot of health out here as well. I could have, if the blood bank had survived longer, I could have used it to gain access to the boss trap room. Because obviously there's a lot of health out here for me to replenish myself. But, sadly, we have no such luck. But actually, we have fantastic luck. Here we are in the Mom's Heart boss fight already. That was actually an incredibly easy floor. Hopefully we'll just be able to actually kill these lasers. There we go. Start dropping bombs. Oh god, I didn't even see that vaginal bomb fly, that it was still alive. I thought it was totally dead. Keep dropping some bombs in here. We got monster. Whoa, the vaginal bomb fly dropped a spirit heart, which is fantastic for us at this point in the game. I don't know how I feel about our chances. I feel like we got a good shot, but I can't be sure if that makes any sense at all. Our laser is certainly doing a hell of a lot of damage here. The Duke of Flies got about an inch and a half before he exploded. And Mom's Heart's about to die. Again, that was super, super easy. Let's head up to the next floor. I'm gonna go ahead and guess that we are probably... I'm gonna use my pony on this. Yeah, there we go. That's exactly what I had anticipated using it for before, where I was like, if you know you're gonna take damage, just use it. Very tempting to use this fake judgment here. Coming across a lot of opportunities that may or may not be awesome. Well, you know, we'll see. If we get a number of heart drops, I've got to blow up this straight here in order to make it possible for me to hit this guy a little bit more effectively. As long as he stays in that center area there. Otherwise, he should be very easy. Of course, do not assume that I've forgotten the tinted rock here. Bust that open, probably get some spirit hearts. Probably get a chest, which I will open and it'll be another chest, and then we'll get Tammy's head. Guppy's head, right? Guppy's head. Okay, Guppy's head we'll use. But we want to stick with the pony as well. But Guppy's head recharges every room, which is pretty useful. It can give us a lot of flies. There's another tinted rock in there. We got money, we got bombs. Okay, so we'll just use that basically as a halo of flies. That was a weird setup. And if I get a lot of heart drops, I'll come back to this, you know, demon judgment. Who may give me some kind of amazing item. Like I said, if I got a flying passive item, I could get rid of the pony, pick up Guppy's head. That wouldn't be so bad. Those are items that help. Hey, Nuns have it. Actually charged up my spacebar item, because I actually used my spacebar item for once. And that would actually allow us to get, like, an unbelievable halo of flies if I had Nuns have it. In conjunction with Guppy's head. Tears up, sure, why not? It's kind of a tricky room for dodges here, but I'm feeling I'll make it out of this okay. You know, it's just the same crowd control you always do. Trying to take out as many of these douchebags as possible. We got another tinted rock, of course that is excellent. Fighting death doesn't bother me. If I could actually like get close enough to hit him. This is when things get a little bit trickier. I'm gonna plant a bomb here, of course. We got a spirit heart out of that tinted rock. I can't help but feel like tinted rocks have been nerfed to, like, provide less spirit hearts. Even though occasionally you still come across two spirit hearts in a tinted rock, it's kind of a rarity now. Which I guess is good for balance, because, like, there were runs where, like, it's been a while since I've had a substantial number of runs where I just had hearts off the screen, which is something that used to happen all the time. Now happens less frequently, although still, you know, from time to time. Okay, so what do we got? We got health here, and we got health here. Let's go back, we'll play that Demon Judgment 2 times, and then we'll scout around for some extra health. You never know, he probably pays out faster than regular Judgment, is my guess. He better, anyway. Okay, we didn't pay out on the first one, nor the second. So now we will go play the slot machine and try to earn some extra hearts off of this. Extra money doesn't matter to me in the least. Extra nothing is even more worthless to me. Come on, I gotta be diligent before this Isaac boss fight. Bad gas. Okay, well, we'll take that. I mean, that could come in handy. I'm not gonna mince words. That was shitty. Let's do a little bit more exploration. You never know what we might come across. Hopefully rooms that are not too difficult, and rooms that drop hearts. I mean, the sloth room should not be so bad. Especially they've both blown up their cover now. Basically, like, one-shotting. If you can one-shot things with technology, I'm one-shotting them with this silkworm. Or one-shotting them with what I got here. Joker! Angel or Devil room. We got the Parasite, and we got the Pact. Let's take the Pact, because that also gives us Spirit Heart. So we functionally lost 0 health. And actually managed to pick some up. And we know we have 1.5 hearts to pick up. So we can play this dude one more time in good conscience. Wow, what an asshole. And otherwise, we'll just go try to pick up some extra health again. Let's see what we got. 3 angel fetuses. You know, provided I don't get hit, we're all okay. Really hoping for heart drops there to make it so I can go back to that demon judgment. Kind of on the fence about whether I should just go fight Blue Baby right now, or if I should, you know, wait it out a little bit. I'll probably go fight him right now. Maybe? Don't want that one. I want this one. Okay, let's get this. If we get more heart drops in these remaining rooms... Oh, this is a bad room. I shouldn't have come here. Plant a bomb, get out! Okay, I've learned my lesson. Onwards to the final boss. So it should be Blue Baby. I'm not gonna fire at him right away. I'm gonna take damage, but I am gonna use bad gas, okay. Now, of course, the problem with this, the problem every time you fight an Isaac or Blue Baby type, when you are using technology is that this asshole is just going to continuously fire shots at you. I really have to make good use of the pony here to give myself invincibility and also do like burst damage, if at all possible. My dodging so- Oh my god, how did that still hit me? My dodging so far has been pretty solid, but I'm still on the fence about my chances for success here. It's kind of a quality dodge there. Oh man, okay. Just keeping it up. Of course, I don't want to get hit, but I also do want the pony charges. Okay, use that. Didn't really do that much damage, but the extra period of invincibility is nice. We should be able to build up some rage on these angel fetuses now. I think we got a good chance. I think we've got a very good chance now, in fact. If I could actually get the hits off here. Imagine how overpowered I would be if I still had that like triple shot that I had before, too. Alright, so Blue Baby's gonna die. We get a spirit heart for it. Awesome. Who cares? Finished the game. Didn't really earn anything else new there, either, but, you know, it was an entertaining run. Anytime you get a full stizing stretch, feels good. Anytime you have... It seems like I've been getting flying a lot, hasn't it? But anytime you get technology, too, it's always an exciting run. For one reason or another, but as always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.